It started to rain pretty hard, and, well, there's a lot of little islands, and it got completely dark. So add all those together, and Matthew got a little turned around. Ladies and gentlemen, I am in the boat with First Mate Pee Poops McToots. I'm accompanied by Captain Funky Jugs and First Mate Stinky Butt Poop Stink. And we have just embarked on a week-long fall wilderness adventure. The colors are absolutely beautiful. And if you watch my video from last week, you'll notice that there's a lot more reds and oranges and stuff back home. Well, here it's all about the yellows and the greens. It's just beautiful. It's perfect out. We're spending 7 nights. We're hoping to catch some fish dinners. We're gonna be staying at multiple different campsites and have a blast. Hopefully we're gonna see some wildlife too. But we got a little bit of a late start as usual, but we've marked an important thing, and that is this is Funk's first trip here that we have not started paddling in the dark. We've actually got a whole 45 minutes till the sun sets. So we've got about 4 miles to paddle across a big old lake. We're gonna try to do it kind of quick and yeah, not have to do too much in the dark, but we are trying to get across this big lake. It's a little breezy, and do one portage and stay at that lake. We'll see how far we get, but let's get to the adventure. Accepted that we're not going to get to that portage and to the next lake tonight. We were staying on this lake. It was a little ambitious to want to do like 10 miles of paddling with an hour of sunlight left. A little ambitious. Maybe it wasn't quite that much, but it was a decent amount. So yeah, we're going to get as far as we can. Right when the sun sets, we're going to find a campsite. And I also wanted to mention that you will not be seeing Funk, if at all. Just know that she's here. She chooses to not be on YouTube, so she doesn't really want to be on in the video. So she's here, but you're not going to see a whole lot of her. That's her choice, and that's just the way it is. Hey, Rooks. How you doing, buddy? You doing good, Rooks? That's a good boy. Yeah, you're going to just settle back into it, huh? It's been a while. This is awesome. The colors are so good. This is like the definition of fall. It's not early fall. It's not late fall. It's as fally fall as fall can be. Smack dab, if there had to be a day that was considered the day of fall, it would be today. I mean, these colors are just perfect. They're just like, just peak season. No leaves are really falling off yet, so temperatures are perfect. It's nice and got that little chill. And sun has just set. So we're gonna paddle for a little bit further, then we gotta find a campsite. Oh, you know, just slowly getting dark. Classic, classic late start. Oh, I got something to say about that late start. That's a late start fart. I am just like a kid in a candy store right now. It's my absolute favorite time of year, doing my absolute favorite style of camping, and just, it's just, with your absolute, with my absolute favorite person and my favorite dogs. That's right. My favorite boat, my favorite area. This is, yeah, this is awesome. This is great. This is gonna be a great week. I'm pumped. I can't stop just like looking at the colors. I'm just like, they're still there. They're still there. Huh? Yeah, blink and all the leaves fall off. It's gonna happen this week. We might see some drastic changes this week just because it's supposed to get pretty cold. It's like the first cold, cold dip. It's not like cold, cold, but it's like 50s. I think it's gonna dip into the 40s and like 20s at night. And this is all Fahrenheit. Yeah, I get into the 20s towards the end of the trip, so we'll definitely see some leaves falling by the end of the week. Oh, if you look over there, there's some more beautiful fall trees. Oh, wow. Make sure to soak it in, because if you blink, it falls over, and they'll all be gone. You and me go paddling in the dark. Will we find a campsite? I hope we will, when the cool winds blow. Baby, I'm ready. Oh, hey, quick little update for you. So, it started to rain pretty hard, and, well, there's a lot of little islands, and it got completely dark. So, add all those together, and Matthew got a little turned around. So currently, we are on an island. I just went and paddled around it, and I'm just pretty sure I know where we're at. The rain has lightened up. It's been raining pretty good. Yeah, this will happen when you get a late start. This is one of the consequences. Funk's just super impressed with me right now, my navigational skills. So, yeah, what we're going to do is, I think I know where we're at. We're going to make sure to be careful, and we're not going, like, crossing islands or anything. We're just going to go along the shore, and I think I know where the campsite is, and if it's not there, we're just turning back around and going the way we came, because we can remember where we came. We know where the points are and everything. So yeah, ding dong, Dingleberry here, but the boys are doing good. Hey, Monty, I'm sorry guys, I'm sorry, Funk. We'll get there. All right, the good news is it turns out I do know where we are. And I figured it out, and there's an angry beaver. Beaver, please. So now we just gotta find the campsite in the dark, just like normal. Completely normal. Right, Funk? You doing good?
Yep.
All right, good job. You're doing great. Everybody's doing great. Beaver, please. Oh yeah, I know you can't see anything right now, but Funk has taken Monty, because he's Monty, and he's used to it a lot more. Ruger sat in the car for 8 hours, and he's just kind of shifting side to side and standing a lot. And he's confused by the angry beaver. So yeah, he's in my boat. Okay, so little update. We ended up finding a campsite. It just took us a couple few extra hours is all. Monty, Ruger, what are you doing? What are you doing, Rugs? What'd you find? This little guy, he's got all sorts of energy. Rugs, come here. What are you doing? What are you doing, you monster? So we are just going to get all set up and get ready to eat some food. We are hungry. We are tired. We are wet. Okay. Wet. Oh, heaven to Betsy. Hi, Monty. Here's your food, Monty. Here you go. Well, we're all set up. Getting water going. Completely all set up. And we are starving. Are you starving?
I'm starving.
I'm starving. So we brought something out that we planned on making tonight, but it's wet and it would require a big rip and fire, lots of firewood. So I'm gonna surprise Funk with a little something. Funk, would you like surprise dinner instead, which would take less than 15 minutes to start eating deliciously?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm pretty starving.
I just want to smash some food right now and like go to bed.
Okay. Surprise dinner is pudgy pies.
That's why you wanted the bread.
That's why I brought out a loaf of bread. All right. We're not going to make a fire. We're going to do this over our stove. So let's make some pudgy pies. Pizza pudgy pies. Oh, yeah. Let's do this.
Yeah, like I said, we had a big meal planned for tonight, but this is easy, quick, and this is going to be just as delicious. So we are going to start with some bread here.
Now, we're not using the pudgy pie maker, so they're going to be, they're still pudgy pies, but they're going to be more like glorified grilled cheeses. If we can serve, we might be able to have some another night. But we might not conserve. We're pretty hungry. We'll see what happens. We're just going to let the good times roll and eat some pudgy pies.
Him.
He is a little.
You like pizza pudgy pies?
Yeah, pizza pudgy pies, guys.
Don't mind if I do.
We got some pizza sauce.
Not going anywhere.
Oh, man. I can serve. We don't have the space to bring in all the extras, so these are just going to be simple, classic peach of pudgy pies. 5 pepperonis per pudgy. 1 layer of cheese for conservation.
You're not going to cheese both sides to make it stick?
Nope. We got to conserve.
Alright.
Okay. Get that on there. Alright. Okay. Take a little bit of butt hair. Oh yeah, here you go. Yes, I can. There you go. There's your pudgy. Ooh. Can I get the spatula? I'm gonna flip mine real quick. Oh my gosh. Uh-oh. I gotta turn down this heat.
Should I turn mine down?
Yeah. Well, that was quick. As this is cooking, I'm gonna get my next pudgy pie loaded up and ready for cooking. Oh, I'm getting hungry. Okay, that's just... Okay, that's... You know what? That's done enough right now.
Can you check mine?
Yeah, I can check it. Get a little more butter going. Get that next round of pudgy pie going. We'll give her the flip to get butter on both sides real quick. Be careful. Ooh, got a little cheese. Hi, Monty. Don't worry, Monty. You're going to get treats, okay? I promise. You hear this? I need this, okay? I need this. It always makes me feel so bad. You got some pepperonis. Don't even look at me like that.
I just learned that my super thin layer that I always bring is,
What?
My super thin layer that I wear.
Mm-hmm.
Just not nearly as warm as normal. And it's so old. It probably does nothing to keep me warm.
Oh.
Oh, I'm so warm already.
Mm. This is so good.
Amazing.
Mm. And I didn't even burn my mouth. Mm. We had to talk about this. I can't be giving you so much bad food. For those of you that are sitting here watching me eat this sandwich in front of him and he's begging, I want you to remember that I've given him, is it 5 bacon cheeseburgers this summer? Yeah, and that's bad for his health. So we've got sweet potatoes, he's going to get fish, he's going to get healthy, good treats later. Just not this. This is bad for me, it'd be terrible for him. It's good for my soul though.
It's gonna be so good.
Oh, it's gonna be so good.
So good.
Yeah, Monty's a champion in the boat. When we switched them, Ruger goes from side to side, he's got the more energy, and Monty just usually chills, but he gave Funk a really hard Monty shift. she was a little nervous there.
I thought I was gonna flip for sure. First time in my life, I thought I was gonna flip the boat.
That would have been terrible. We're just reminiscing how Funk's been trying all week to not get us a late start. It's actually her fault that we got one today.
Yeah. I said, I'm like a get there 15 minutes early kind of person.
I mean, I am too sometimes with some things every once in a while, but, you know, I tried. Embrace it. Yeah, the rain. That was fun. That was just a good start to a good adventure. Oh.
Without fail. Without fail.
Yeah. Oh. Monty, you're making me feel terrible, but I have to stay strong. You may not know it, but not giving you treats is for you. Okay? For your longevity of your life. I feel like an endless pit right now. I think I could eat 7 or 8 of these. I swear I could just keep eating them, but I'm gonna stop after this 5th one. They're so good. Alright, so I'm gonna finish this up and we're gonna get in that tent and get ready for bed.
Oh, hey, Steve. Steve. Oh, Steve.
Oh, Rugs. That was at the camera, not you. Rugs, don't do it. All right, lay down, Rugs. Lay down, Rugs. Come here, lay down. Okay. We have a tight fit here in the tent. Yeah. So that was a fun first day. We're all in the tent now. We've got all the space maxed out in here. I'm pooped. You know, I really could have ate more of those sandwiches, but 5 was good. I'm satisfied. I'm not stuffed. I'm satisfied. It's very foggy and muggy, but it's chilly out. Anyways, yeah, interesting first day. You know, Funk's, you know, our first time out here, we paddled in the dark in the snow, which was actually much more difficult than the rain today. So now it's rain. But anyways, we're gonna pass out, we're gonna sleep in, we will catch you guys in the morning. Good night, everybody.
Oh, stop it. Oh, don't do that. Oh, Rooks, please. Please, Rooks, please. Oh, please. Please, Rooks. Rooks, please.
Good morning.
Whoa, Rooks. Ruger, stop.
What's the matter with you?
Oh, Rooks. He's... Ruger.
Get out of here.
Ruger. He was jumping on the tent. Funk's already up with the dogs. Oh, I slept great last night. Funk was snoring all night.
Okay.
She says the fall colors are still out there, so I need to get up and go check them out and see them before they're, all the leaves fall. So let's go. Let's do it.
Did it start raining, Monty? Oh, there's a good boy. It started raining, Monty. It started raining.
Okay, so it started raining. We got the boys in the tent. It's lighting up a little bit, but we're going to just cook breakfast in the tent here. So I'm going to queue up my coffee and oatmeal sequence right now in the tent. Let's do it. This morning we are having Funk's homemade dehydrated rice and beans. A little on the soupy side, that's okay with me. I like it soupy. She had one extra of these for me to use. I decided to not bring them out for this, but I'm just going to eat it normally each time except for this first one. A little tortilla. And then we've got a Nalgene full of hot sauce. I'm just going to drizzle some of that on there. Oh yeah, there we go. Drizzle a little bit in here. There we go. So this is just typical fall weather so far. Raining, cold, cloudy. Love it. It seems like it's gonna just, there's just a chance of rain every day. Oh man. I wish I'd have brought out more tortillas now. So yeah, right now the DSLR is sitting under a tree where it's dry. I'll give you a shot of the fall colors in a second here, but I have to wait for the rain to stop because I don't want to ruin my camera. Or, you know what? We'll give a quick shot, but anyways, we're gonna get finished packing up here in the rain. It's just drizzling, it's a light rain, and then we're gonna get in the water, get to moving. But let's do a quick little shot of the colors before I pack that thing away.
Look at that back there. It's a little foggy looking because of the rain, but that's all actually in the burn. All that back there. Let's see if we can get that in focus. Right there. Yeah, that's all in the burn, you can tell. This actually makes it more colorful, more yellow. This is not, that little island's not in the burn. So that's what it would look like more so if all that was not, there was not a fire that ripped through there. You can see all just the beautiful colors. That's what we're dealing with. And these two stinkers.
So Rooks doesn't have a rain poncho. Come here, Rooks.
You gotta get your cute little...
I think that'll do.
Yeah, good boy, Rooks.
Good boy, Rooks. You're a little garbage. Come here. Come here. Come on.
wearing things is like this kryptonite.
Monty, Ruger, come here. Come on. Oh, all right. Well, we'll have to fix it up. Let's fix this up.
What we've got here is a Bushcraft doggy rain poncho.
Hi, Rooks. Come here, Rooks. Come here. Come here. Hi. Hi, little guy. Oh, look at you in your little rain poncho, Rooks. That's a good boy. That's a good boy.
All right, first mate. Stinky butt. Let's go. Come on. Come on right here. No, Rooks. Right here. Yeah. Come on. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, and we are off. See, Ruger, he shifts pretty hard. So while we're on this big lake, the biggest lake of the trip, and until Ruger gets, you know, some more settled in, he's going to be in my boat because I am the more experienced paddler. So I will be taking the stinky butt poop stink, Mr. Rugus Tugus, because he's a little turd. See, you've got this Monty. Maybe you got your Monties that settle instantly. Whatever vessel they're in, he's just a good boy. That's a good boy, Rugus. Yeah, look at you. He's learning. He's learning to settle. Slowly but surely. Yeah.
I just realized something, and that's that I'm not trolling right now. I haven't cast a line yet. I mean, what am I thinking? Who am I?
So as far as fish goals this trip, our main focus is Larry the Lake Trout for the next today, tomorrow, and the next day. We got 3 days of Larry the Lake Trout catching, and then the season is closed. So that is the immediate goal. Beyond that, I can't say until we get there, but we are just focused on the Larry. And we're not gonna really be at a Larry Lake till tomorrow. So we're gonna have 2 days of Larry fishing. 2 days. We want to catch some Larrys. We want to have some Larry tacos. Larry tacos, that's the goal. But we'll take Bobby tacos. You don't want no Peter tacos. We'll take Walter tacos. Yeah. But Larry tacos are going to be the best tacos.
And it burns, 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 the rude desire, the Rugie's Rugs. Why don't you stand, oh stinky Rugs? Please just lay down, please lay down, yes. Lay down, Rugs. Lay down, Rugs. Come on. Come on. Oh, that's such a good boy. That's such a good boy.
Rugs, have a drink. And one day you will lay down on your own free will in the back of a canoe. Yes. Yes, you, Rugs.
Yep, yeah, last time me and Funk were out here, we were with Monty. He was 8 months old. We did a 12-night wilderness adventure. We actually started on this lake. That's when the snow was happening at night on our first night's paddle. And I will link that video up here in the left. Left for link. But we're kind of, I would say this one's kind of a legacy trip because we're doing 7 nights, so we're doing a portion of that trip. But, yeah, that was a fun trip. Monty looked a little scruffy and scraggly in that trip because he was, he had bad allergies and he was scratching his face. But now he's just a poof. He's just a big old poof.
Oh, oh, there's a big old beaver home.
I have to cast near it. I will just hate myself in the morning.
Oh, Rugus. If I don't cast near it. Oh, Dang. Yeah, I just had a bite. I couldn't really tell. It could have been a... I think it was a fish. 30% chance of me... Oops. That was a great cast. Oh, rogues.
Well, it's just gorgeous out there. Just gorgeous.
Good boy, Rubes. So big bundle of twigs over there. Nope. No fish there. Nope. Two casts, no bites, no fish.
Don't worry about it. I'll explain later.
Oh, that's a good boy, Rooks. That's a good boy. Yeah, you got your little garbage bag on. Yeah, that's a good boy. Okay.
Well, that was a fun little portage. So the reason that was so fun is because last time, like 4 years ago, I think when we were here, we skipped that portage. And I gave myself a little piece of advice. So if you ever got the choice between pulling your boat through rocks and rushing water and a 30 rod portage, take the 30 rod portage every time, because it was not fun. Matthew, Monty, and Aaron suggest taking the portage. Don't you think so, Monty? Just do the portage?
Yeah, so I thought right there is where you got out, because we didn't want to deal with the same thing we dealt with last time, and that's not where you get out for the portage, so we had to walk through the water and over like rocks, because we already had loaded up our gear, didn't feel like reloading our boats. So I already moved the paddles and everything, and it was super skinny. So that's why I was using little sticks there to move. Rogues, sit down. Sit down there, guy. Yeah, sit down. Oh, good boy. That's a good boy, Rogues. That's a good Rogues.
I mean, does it get any better than this? I don't know. Look at it out there.
It's gonna be hard to pick up on the GoPro, but there is a bald eagle on the tip of that tree right there, just watching us. He's just looking at us like, what are you doing?
right, we're having a little lunch, having a little tuna tacos, got some flavored tuna, cabbage, and cheddar cheese on tortillas. Funk's adding a little hot sauce to hers. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. A little baby taco.
Yeah, you got a little baby taco.
I got a man taco.
Wait, that doesn't sound right at all.
I got a man taco.
All right, Rugal Badugal, come on. Come on. In you go, go ahead. In you go, go ahead, get in. Come on, good boy.
Oh, you might have to pick up Monty. He's like that sometimes. But you got him? You just deadlifted a full Monty?
Yeah, bro. Basically my workout making me.
Yeah. All right, so we have just snacked up, ate some lunch. Boys got some snacks. And we've got two more portages for the day. We've done the major paddling for the day. We've gone across the bigger lakes. Now we've got a little bit of a paddle. Definitely enough time to drop a line and troll for a Larry. And then portage. Then we've got a teeny little pond, then portage, and then we are on our lake for the evening. So yeah, we're gonna get out here to where it's deep enough, and I'm gonna drop a line and troll. The boys are having fun. Ruger's actually getting better in the boat. He's a lot better than yesterday. Yesterday in the dark, I mean, I wonder why, after sitting in 8 hours and then just going into a boat into the dark and a big lake and stuff, he just was a little restless. Anywho, he's better today. He's sitting more often and he's laying down for longer. But he's not sitting on his own yet and laying down like a Monty. Monty just gets in the boat, immediately lays down, chin up, he's chilling. Ruger's not there yet, but we have hope. We have hope. Lay down, Rugs. Lay down. Lay down, Rugs. Lay down. Oh, that's a good boy. That's such a good boy. Funny, one thing I've never ever got to experience is Monty looking at me while I'm riding another boat. He's such a cutie pie. It's just his little head and he's just looking at us like, hey, you look familiar. What's going on? Yeah, he's just watching. Monty, are you a good boy? Yeah. Yeah, he's got the boat life figured out. That's for sure.
Ruger, you're getting there. You're gonna get it.
Lay down. Yeah, lay down. Do it all the way. The whole way.
Oh, good boy. There he is. There he is.
Yeah, he still needs some coaxing. But I have hope still. I won't give up that hope until the trip's over. My prediction, I think, in the video I made a couple weeks ago was that by day two he'd be sitting down laying on his own, but I'm gonna push that back a couple days. I think in day four he'll be choosing to lay on his own.
Sit down. Miss, please. Oh, do me a favor. Sit down. What a good, good boy. Yes. Oh, what are you doing now? Oh. What? What's going on back there?
Would you please sit down, sir? Please. Please. Please sit down. Sit down, Ruiz. You sit down now.
Good boy. Okie dokes, we are on our lake for the evening. We've got a couple miles, or let's see, at least a mile to paddle to for the first campsite. And then we're actually gonna be getting out of the burn in a mile and a half to 2 miles. And what that's gonna mean is we're gonna see probably a lot less of the colored trees, the yellows and whatnot. A lot more pines and whatnot. So a lot more green, a lot less yellow. They'll still be in there, but it'll just be more green. This is all in the burn, it's all that, those young trees and whatnot that's got all the leaves.
Do you wanna see? Do you wanna go for dog dog? All right, good boy. Okay, hi puppies. Hi Rugus, hi Monty. Come here, Monty. Hi, hi Monty, hi. Hi you stinker, what's that? What is that, Monty? All right, so we are at our campsite for the evening. We have got an hour of sunlight left. Funk's working on setting up the tent and I am gonna work on getting firewood. And then we're gonna bring back some pieces, get it processed up and get a fire going, cause we've got a big old delicious dinner to make tonight. So yeah, she's setting up. I'm gonna get to the firewood, not gonna record a whole lot of it, but yeah, let's get to it. Okay, as you can see, it's getting dark out. We're just processing up some wood here. Camp's all set up. We got a nice little spot here. You can see the burn. It starts right over here. You can see half of it where it starts and it ends. And there's still a nice mix of colors in there, which I'm happy for.
Let's chop some of this.
Thank you.
funk. Could you go get us some more firewood, please? We don't have enough. Some weird birch bark.
It's fresh. And it's wet.
Punk's got her butt out. She's roasting her butt.
It's my butt cheeks are cold.
Oh, so we got the fire going. It is hot. I don't even need my jacket on. It's toasty. We're just relaxing. Firewood's all cut up. We're just going to burn this down because there's no way we can cook on this right now. It's just a little too hot. So we're letting this burn down in a nice coal bed, and then we're going to get cooking. And tonight we are having big ol' thick ribeye steaks with Brussels sprouts and mashed potatoes. Oh yeah, it's gonna be delicious. And we're pooped.
Yeah.
We didn't really move that far today, but we're pooped, we're hungry. So.
We didn't drink any water all day.
Yeah. We're just gonna burn this down and then it's time to prepare dinner.
I love a good steak, look at these two. He's got it. Oh, Rook, are you gonna get it? Get it, Rooks. Oh, Monty sniped. Oh, wait, did he? We set him up a mini game of find the treats. Ready, Monty? Alright, find the treats. Go ahead.
Find the treats, Rooks.
Monty, you're way off. Hey, Funk, how's your new hoodie? Funk's cutting up the boy's sweet potato. Oh yeah, Brussels. To this heaping pile of Brussels, we're gonna add this little itty bitty chunk of butter.
and just a light flavoring of the greatest spice there ever was.
Montreal steak seasoning. A little bit more there. Okay. Let's keep that on the fire. Alright, we need the dogs too. There you go. Oh, this is so hot. Ah, it's burning my leg. Oh, get them taters going. Oh, I'm gonna feast so hard. Yep. It's gonna be so good. Oh, it's mine. All right, my water for potatoes ready. Yours is not.
Oh, no.
What happened?
A little chunk ripped off.
Oh no.
Great.
Oh, this fire's so hot. Uh-huh. Okay. Oh, geez. Oh, it's so hot.
Oh, that smell.
Funk insists that I bring out tongs. So here we are. This is where we are now.
Tastes better though, hey? And I don't like when you burn yourself, personally.
No? Okay. Huh?
I don't mind it having a little fire. Yeah, it's pretty perfect, actually. Monty, you have to get out of here. You little silly stink.
It's so beautiful. Oh. Yeah, that's done. I'll put it on these Brussels and then, yeah. Where you want yours?
Just set it off to the side for a second. I just want to kind of warm this up.
How is it?
I mean, it was all fat.
Oh, okay.
But.
Got the boys' sweet potato and steak, my steak and Brussels that are sitting under there. Oh yeah, mashed potatoes. Okay, let's feast. I'm gonna actually eat mine with a fork and knife today so my hands don't get super greasy, but you know, sophisticated. You are such good boys. Go ahead. Just, they were so ready for that. Oh yeah.
do it. Fork and knife. I never eat a steak like this. Not even at home. What's going on here? This piece is so tender. How's yours?
It's good. It's really good. I'm gonna eat it all.
Mm-hmm.
I just love the Brussels. No offense. Yeah, I love the steak, obviously.
I am struggling eating this with a fork and knife. I'm about to just give up on the whole thing. Is doing the smart thing. It's starting to sprinkle, and it's starting a little bit ago, but starting to pick up. And we have our stuff kind of all laying out because we just set up the tent. We've just been preparing firewood and just kind of left it. She's doing the smart thing, putting all her stuff packed away. But I'm in a place right now. And that is just food monster heaven.
What?
I'm in food monster heaven right now.
Oh, I know, it's so good. I can't wait to get back to it.
I kind of don't care if my stuff gets wet right now. Hey. How's it going? He's sitting next to me, really close for some reason. Oh, hey, how's it going? How are you guys doing? Doing good? I'm probably gonna set down my food here and put some of my stuff away. Or not, I can't decide. But either way, I'm gonna shut off the camera, finish eating, get all everything cleaned up, and we're gonna get in the tent and get ready for bed. What's about to happen to the rest of this food ain't gonna look pretty and ain't made for the internet.
Ruger, what's this? Hi. Are you a good boy?
One sure way to know you're dealing with a Monty is the massive overbite. He can never close his mouth. So that's 100% Monty right there. No way that's an imposter.
But anyways, I am like pretty uncomfortably full. I just like been flopping around trying to get all everything cleaned up, but we ate deliciously. Yeah, it was a good day. So we're going to pass out. I'll catch you guys in the morning. Good night, everybody. Good morning. Oh. I am all alone in the tent. Funk has stolen my dogs. And I've been abandoned. She's got a fire started. There's a light rain going on. This trip has been different from my other trips. We're getting all rain and cloudy, which is nice. A nice change of pace. This is what I'm used to. But I think it's time to get up. Make some breakfast. Meow.
Monty. Hi, puppy. Rugus. Oh, no, no, don't do that. Hi, Rugs. Okay, see ya.
Hi, Monty. Hi, Rugus. Hi. Oh, don't you bark at me. Oh, you stinkers.
You look at your wet doggies.
You got that stick, Monty? Oh, you got that stick? Okay. What are you gonna do with that stick, Monty?
Oh, I got the power. I got the power. Oh, geez. Hey. Oh, it deflected. You guys are both missing it. Okay, so we've got another rainy little morning. Got the tarp set up. Putting all stuff under there. We've got a nice little fire going.
Oh, yeah. Punk got a good fire going. We're putting all our extra firewood under this log here as best we can to keep it dry for the next person. We've got a wet Rogues and a sopping wet Monty. I wanted to bust out the DSLR so I could zoom in and show you guys the contrast, but you can just see it. If you look, oh, I don't know if this GoPro will pick it up, but right here's a little island, and on this side of the island right there is still in the burn. See how it's all kind of still mostly yellow, except right on the water's edge. And then right to the right of the island, you can see it's out of the burn. There's tons of pines all mixed in there, but there's still lots of yellows and still really beautiful all back up in there. All up in there.
All right, it's raining, so I'm using the GoPro. Not gonna bring out the DSLR, but we're having a good old-fashioned three-course monster breakfast this morning. We're having red skin potatoes cooked up in butter with some liquid scrambled eggs, maybe a little cheese on there, and bacon. So we need to prepare the feast. And if the boys are good, they might get a piece of bacon. Even though they're not supposed to, and I'm going back on everything I just said two videos ago about how they're gonna start eating healthier, and I'm gonna stop feeding them things like bacon and too much steak fat. Well, you know, it's just hard when they're staring at you with their cute little faces.
Well, that's the potatoes process.
Bacon. A pound and a half of bacon. Oh, I'm just kidding. Let's just pop in a teeny little chunk of butter to those potatoes. And a wee little bit of Montreal steak seasoning. Oh, we'll do a little bit more. Okay, let's get the cooking.
Okay. We're eating good today. Are you ready for this? Yummy eggs. Yummy. Ooh, Punk's over here cooking me breakfast. Oh yeah, all egg slop, yeah. Fire, bacon, potatoes, eggs, fire, potatoes, eggs, fire, eggs via eggs, eggs, potatoes, eggs, potatoes, bacon, potatoes, eggs, potatoes, bacon, eggs, bacon, potatoes, eggs, bacon.
Give the dogs a piece of bacon. That's a good piece. We don't give them that one. How much eggs for them? Like that?
Okay, breakfast is served. Let's eat.
Ruger, you didn't even chew that piece of bacon.
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah. Made myself some coffee. It feels like it's super hot.
I want more of those Brussels from last night.
Thinking about the Brussels?
Yeah.
I'm thinking about that top part of the ribeye.
That was good too, but...
It's just like butter. It's for your health that you get less bacon and stuff, huh? We're gonna finish up our breakfast, clean up our dishes, and pack away, and then get under that water and get to moving. We got 4 portages today. 3 are pretty small. 1 is, they're all pretty small. It's a pretty small portage trip, which is the way we planned it, but there's less daylight now, so yeah, we're going to still have to move. But anyways, out of all the dishes you'll have to clean if you're cooking out here in the woods, bacon grease after cooking bacon is always the worst, and all these pans had like bacon and butter in them, and like that one especially, it's just got charred bacon. Those are always the roughest to clean, so we're going to need to get the fire going. That's going to take a minute, but yeah, we're just going to clean up and get moving.
Yeah, you're eager, huh? Okay, Rooks. All right, good job.
Whoa! And we... Let the record show that Rugus Tugus Butt Badugus, first mate Stinky Butt Poopstink, has sat for the first time voluntarily in the boat. No words were said, he just chose to sit.
Good boy, Rugus.
Now you get to do the next step, but I'm not telling you to do it. We'll let you figure it out on your own.
So you can see right here is the line of the burn. To the right is the burn, and to the left, it's unburned. And these fires were years ago, but still, you can see all the pine trees and all the green and how it's just young little trees with all the leaves over here. I mean, there's still some big ones that survived, but for the most part, yeah. And then we're going out of the burn all over there. All those rolling hills, that's all out of the burn.
Rugus Dugus Otmadugus has chosen to lay down on his own free will. For the first time ever, on day 3 of the 8-day wilderness. You're such a good boy, Rooks. Very good choice.
Alright, I'm taking like 4 casts. Ruger, leave it. Leave it, Rugs. Good boy. Oh. Really good boy, Rugs. That's exactly what I wanted. No bites, 2 casts, no fish in this lake.
That's told you there's no fish in this lake after my 2 casts yesterday.
Oh yeah, you're right. You did.
I think you took like 7 casts this morning.
7 casts this morning? Oh my gosh, that's 13 combined casts and we didn't get a single bite. There is absolutely not even a chance of this fish in this lake. I am offended that this lake would be here without fish in it. Try fishing, okay, buddy? Just take a few casts. We're gonna fish this lake a little bit for some fish, you know? Fish for fish. But I'm gonna work my way out of the wind here. Ruger, sit please. Sit. 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 Yes, good boy. Hey, stop that. What are you doing?
Rugus. Oh, jeez, Rugus. Oh.
And that was what we call a pike. Snap my line. Dang it. I just had a pike snap my line. Oh, really? Dang it. It's getting bright out. The sun's about to poke out. Oh, even though the sun's not out and it's completely cloudy still, it's still pretty bright.
Roots. There we go.
What do we got here? Uh-oh, it's a pike. Uh-oh. Oh, dang nabbit! Dang it! Dang it! That was a decent-sized pike. I could definitely see his body in the water. Dang it! What the heck? For me, the whole dead tree. Wow, you're the best. That's all it's biting.
Yeah.
Till we get some Larry's.
I saw the pike almost bite my line, and he snapped to yours. So I'm just like, I'm good on that, you know?
Yeah, I'm good on that right now. No matter how many snap lines I get, I don't go back to steel eaters anymore. Leave it, Rooks. Ooh, almost got a snag. Okay.
I think with the right amount of practice, a Ruger would really be a good
fish.
Oh!
Oh! I didn't feel him bite it. He just slowly grabbed that one. That was a nice fish, too.
Was it a pike?
I don't know what that was. Dang it! What is it?
What?
Blue sklies.
Oh.
Hey, they do exist. Yep, that's the first little glimpse of the blue sky we've seen in 3 days. Blue sklies. Blue sklies. Nothing but blue sklies. Now, I know it may seem like we're not fishing too hard, and that's because the goal is for lake trout. And the only 2 days that we can keep lake trout are today and tomorrow. So we're kind of pushing through. 2 more portages left, and then we're gonna do some trolling on that lake. We've got 5 hours of light left, so we can get the next 2 done in a couple hours at least. Easy, probably sooner than that. And yeah, then we can go for some Larry's. That's pretty much why we're not fishing much. We're just banking on the Larry's. Putting a lot of faith in the Larry's. It's what always happens this time of year. My one trip where the last light on the last day of lake trout season, and the last spot I was gonna try right at sunset, and then that whole situation happened. I waited all day for you, Larry. I've waited all day for you. That was my first cast. Then, on Fat Lake, I got fat and sassy, but I actually got that one that time. So we traveled all this way to Fat Lake. Didn't catch a lake trout. Didn't catch Larry. It's disappointing. Wait. Is this Larry? Oh, shit. Yeah. And then this trip is the most recent one where it's right on the board. The other ones have been after. The sun! The sun is out. Hello, the sun. How do you do? It's been a minute since we've seen you. I don't know if our Monty is safe anymore with Funk. She just hit him in the face with her seat. I would never, ever hit Monty in the face with anything, ever. Oops. You good, Monty?
Spin attack! Boom!
Monty, are you safe with her?
I don't know, Dad. I don't know. Something's going on, I don't know about it. But it feels the same. What the heck?
Funk was just talking about how as a little teeny tiny 8-week-old puppy, I threw Ruger down the stairs at our old place. And it wasn't voluntary, obviously. I was holding the cute little puppy Ruger because he had to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night. And I was just carrying him down the stairs because this is when he was so small, he just wasn't ready for going downstairs yet. And the stairs were wet and I was wearing my Crocs and my robe and just, you know, middle of the night storming down the stairs and just slipped and fell right on the stairs and landed on my elbow and threw Ruger. And he was like screaming. He was like, running back up the stairs inside the house. And I was in so much pain. I was just like, I definitely hurt myself pretty good, but I like walk inside. I'm like, is he okay? And Funk's like, what about you? That I'm used to in one of these trips. All my trips before this were all sunshine and blue skies the whole time. This one started off rainy and wet for the most part, cloudy. and who knows where it's going. But I always prefer to have my rain and cloudy and wetness all right in the beginning, because then it's much more rewarding to get sun, to just get, you know, get all wet and be like, ah, okay, bro, I'm wet. And then get all sunny and dried out and then just chillaxing. It's like it knows. The weather knows we're going for Larry's soon. So she's like, here you go, here's some sun. Get ready to catch them. We're gonna catch so many fish. Right, Funk, how many fish are you gonna catch? All of them? Are you sure? What about me? I can have some? All right. Okay, I'll take it. As long as I can have some.
Alright, come on in. Woo!
Good boy, Roos. Oh. Okay, so we are on our lake for the evening and the next two evenings. No more portaging for the next three nights. So I'm gonna drop a line. Oh, and we're gonna do some trolling. Now we've got today and tomorrow to catch Larry's. If we catch anything today, we're probably not gonna eat it up. It's cold enough to where we can just fillet it up and keep the fillets. I think what the plan is right now is to find one of the first few, find a campsite pretty quick here. We've got, let's see, 2 hours and 40 minutes of daylight left. So we'll find a site quick here, and then we're gonna, Funk wants to get up early in the dark and do some morning fishing. Something I don't think I've done in quite some time, surprisingly. I have not been morning fishing really at all. And morning's the best time. So, we're gonna do it. At least we're gonna try, right? Unless I get too late of a start in the morning, you know. You'll kill me?
No more late starts.
No more late starts? I don't know if that's gonna happen.
Late start as much as you want.
Yeah. No more funky late starts? Okay, we are at our campsite for the evening. I've actually been here before. When I was on this lake and it was just a torrential downpour, I was heading to this campsite and there's some people here and they called me in and I hunkered down while big old thunderstorm ripped through. Couldn't even see across this lake in this spot. Oh yeah, that's a beautiful view. I think we're gonna set up some hammocks right here. I brought out the hammock. So we're gonna relax in the hammock for a bit and then we're gonna get set up.
Whoa. Oh. Oh geez.
Is it a tree?
No, it was the dog attacking me and it slipped a little.
Oh yeah.
Hi Rugus. Come here. Come here. Come on. Come here. Stay there. Oh. Stay. Yeah.
So, we have just been relaxing. We got all set up. I gathered some firewood, but it's been off and on rain the whole time. Right after the, or actually right the last clip I showed, right after that, it started to sprinkle and then just rain for a little bit. Then it stopped and it's rained again. And now we're hearing thunder, so we're kind of just like the heck with firewood and fire tonight if it's just gonna rain. So yeah, so we're just gonna cook under here tonight. And well, what are you gonna have for dinner?
Sketty.
Sketty? I'm kind of ready for sketty, but we do have the stuff to make pudgy pies, so I have a choice to make. Also, Funk could make a spaghetti sandwich if she chose.
I might just eat the spaghetti. I might have a piece of bread, though.
Piece of bread?
Yeah.
You can have the butt.
Oh, nobody likes the butt.
It, you gotta use it. It's so good. It's so much better. It's actually the best piece.
You're lying. Nobody believes that.
I'm not gonna have a spaghetti sandwich. I'm gonna have straight up pudgy pies. Really? Funk squished the bread.
You gotta squish it.
Alright, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 sandwiches worth and the butt.
You can make a pudgy pie out of the butts and give me one piece of normal bread.
You have 2.
Alright, I'll have 2.
You want it right now?
Yeah, I just want to eat 2 pieces of bread right now. No, I want it with my spaghetti.
Then I can have 3 pudgy pies, or 4 pudgy pies with the butt. Would that be enough to satiate me? No, I want I love pudgy pies.
They're not real pudgy pies. They're like the Walmart version of pudgy pies.
If you start raiding in my parade right now...
Equate pudgy pies.
Get out of town. Get out of here.
Oh, it was lightning.
What?
Yeah.
A good bolt?
I didn't see the bolt, but it lit up the whole sky. I can't believe you just missed that.
Oh. Oh, let me mix it up for you. We got some boiling water and some pumpkin for him. We got an extra ooey gooey for him.
Oh, he did get the mouse.
What?
Yeah.
He got it?
Yep.
Oh, so what I was going to say is, Roog saw a mouse and chased after it and knocked over my camera and it almost smoked the lens on a rock. But luckily he just broke the light off the top and I got it kind of just set on there with, it's just barely on there. But apparently he got the mouse.
Yeah, it's dead.
Well, go ahead boys, eat your food.
I like how you just had your pudgy pies on your lap and you were just like, it's gone. I was throwing my sandwiches away. Yeah,
I was making my pudgy pies and I was sitting here like this, just had them near, and like I watched the camera falling and I was just like, there's nothing I can do. I've got pudgy pies, and Funk threw her food and jumped up and tried to save it. Okay, so out of nowhere, the wind's picked up. It's starting to go like crazy. It just, it's getting gusty. It's getting windy all of a sudden. Super windy. It was dead calm. But we were hearing thunder, so this could be the storm just rolling in. We'll see. Ooh. Ooh, a little crispy on that side. Okay, this one's done. Okay, this could make a mess, but let's try to do the ooey gooey. Ooh. Oh yeah.
Look at that cheesy, delicious, ooey gooey pizza, pudgy pie. Oh yeah.
Okay.
Oh man, I could just eat these forever. Funk made our spaghetti this time around, so she's excited to try it out. Right?
Yep.
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 It's getting chilly with the wind. Funk's all bundled up.
I am. Mm-hmm. I sure am. If I cut this off, my whole hat just like unravels.
Oh, okay. Well, the rain's starting. No, pretty good. Pudgy pie number 3. Monty laid down. You little dirty turd. Armonte's becoming unruly. So, we're hoping that this doesn't affect the fishing tomorrow, because tomorrow's the day we're trying the hardest for fish. Probably out of the whole trip. Maybe. No, we'll try pretty hard if we get desperate, but still. Yeah, we're gonna try to get up in the dark, get up really early, do a nice morning fish, and yeah, that's the plan. So, kind of hope it keeps raining all night because it's peaceful. But yeah, I've got one more pudgy pie after this, and then we are going to clean up our crap and get in that tent, get ready to pass out early tonight. So, yeah, I'll check back in with you guys in a little bit.
That's Mama's stuff.
Don't let him wait for my stuff.
What? There you go, little guy.
Oh, there you go. Oh.
Yep, this is your little spot, Rugus. That's the spot, Rooks. Good boy. Lay down, Rooks. Yep. Gotta... There it is.
Okay. Oh, I got my two stinky doggies.
Well, that was a delicious little meal. Got some rain, stuff like that. Wind, sun. But, yeah. We're gonna pass out, try to get up early, and then maybe do some morning fishing. So, I will catch you guys in the morning.
Good night, everybody. You come here, Monty.
Rooks. Stop. Rooks, stop.
What are you doing,
Rooks? It's so bright. Hey, good morning. It's dark. Get super dark in here. Super dark outside. Making some noises over there. Okay, we're getting up. It's happening. This is real life. Let's do it. Yeah.
As you can see, we are still sleeping.
Why that is. So the wind's howling around like crazy. So we didn't feel like battling the wind on this big, big old lake.
So we just decided we're going to probably stay here tonight. But, well, Funk got Rugs a little riled up and...
I did not. I did not.
What happened?
Nobody did anything wrong.
What happened?
He popped my air mattress.
Ruger popped Funk's sleeping pad. With which paw?
The one foot I forgot to trim his nails on. I trimmed all three of them and then somehow I forgot a whole foot.
And there's three perfect little holes. Well, let me see the sleeping pad.
Scrap it, just like...
There's the three little holes. One, two, three. A perfect little paw. So we're going to try patching that in a little bit. Otherwise, Funk's sleeping on the ground the rest of the
Whatever.
Trip.
Whatever, I'm taking their mattress. They're sleeping on the ground.
Okay, I've got a bunch of these patch kits, and I'm going to try it. So basically I got the holes here, I used an alcohol rub or wipe to clean it completely and I'm just letting it dry. It should be dry by now. So the next step is to press in the glue dots. Now, I tried one of these winter camping. It didn't work out so well. To work the glue into the fibers and press multiple times very hard. So I'm just going to keep mashing this in here. Here I've already got one patch applied and then two more glue dots are going on. I don't know how well this is going to work with these two being side by side. At least sticking better than last time. Okay. Okay, patches are applied. Now the last test is to blow it up, see if it works. Funk!
What?
I think it worked!
Yay! Good job.
Only time will tell, but I mean, I got my ear pressed up to it and I don't hear or feel anything. Well, gee! Yeah, you, mister! No, you stay away. You stay away. You're the one that did this. The Rugus.
Yeah, you've got two under your belt. Two. It's kind of, the first one was my fault. This one, I don't know what happened, but me and you.
Well, that ain't the first sleeping pad we've popped. Oh no. What could have caused a hole? Ah!
And it won't be the last. Sound in the mic. Folks volunteered to go get Larry all on her own.
Yeah. You betcha.
You betcha.
My chief.
Get it, Rooks. He just didn't like that. He's super mad.
Alright, it's not that breezy for the moment, but it's definitely gusting and windy. So, what the plan is I'm gonna eat some breakfast here. And then I'm going straight down that way, all as far as you can see, in search of Larry. Quest for Larry today. I just need some breakfast. And, look at that nice beaver stick for the boys. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. I just got the urge to poop, too. What's going on? I didn't poop yesterday. Anyways, yeah, breakfast, poop, stick. Then we're going to go get Larry. That's what's happening.
I got you, Monty. I got the Monty. All right, so I'm just getting ready to make some breakfast, but thinking about it. Oh yeah, we moved our tarp, but thinking about the wind, the more I look out there and how breezy it is, the less I want to go fishing. Monty. Do you want to come with me if I go fishing, or do you want to stay here in the, out of the wind?
I don't want you to go.
You don't want me to go?
No, I'll be scared the whole time you're gone.
The whole time?
The whole time.
The whole time. All right, I'll stay. Yeah, we can just relax. We'll just have to catch Larry another year. Larry slipped away once again. There's still hope that it might calm down later. If it calms down later, we're for sure going out, but it's just so breezy right now, and without having all our gear, like if we were gonna pack up and move, if I was weighed down like that, it'd be not a big deal to troll around, but without the dogs and without all my gear, I'd be blowing around and I'd be sitting out of the water too much to be comfortable. So, what I mean is, Dad's gonna stay. Oh, I'm so happy. Dad's gonna stay. Oh, I'm so happy.
Okay. Let's cue up the coffee and oatmeal sequence. Go!
Best. Good boys. Pretty? Good boy. Monty, sit pretty? Nope, come here. Oops. Sit. Sit pretty? Good boy, Monty. Sit pretty? Wave. Yes, good boy.
Soupy oatmeals.
Well, hot. And it's cool.
So yeah, we're just relaxing. We're probably gonna set up the hammocks right here. It's a lot chillier when you get out away from this tarp. And it is just getting windier and windier. So yeah, I think we're just gonna play cards, hang out, enjoy the day relaxing, the sound of the breeze, throw the stick for the boys here, maybe set up a game of FINDTHETREATS. You know what I'm saying? They don't know what I'm saying. That spells find the treats, if you were wondering. It's breezy out there. Let's go take a peek. Peek!
Let's go take a peek at that. Entertainment, dogs. Yes.
Who's a good boy?
Now I know it's vicious, but this is actually them playing. If they were actually fighting, it would be a lot crazier than this. I like how Monty throws fists. Good boy, that's the one. Good boy.
Three candies.
Call.
Six candies. I got a pack of tens.
Damn.
Okay, I am back in Davout. Today has been a nice day of extreme napping, extreme hammocking, extreme relaxation. We've got an hour of light left. The winds have just now finally calmed down. There's no more white caps. It's just a little calm. Funk's throwing in the towel. She's decided she is not getting in her boat at all today. So I'm going to go troll for a good half hour, 45 here. Now we're going to try for a Larry. It's always funny how it gets down to just the last couple days every year when we're just going for them Larrys. It's always some kind of difficulty catching Larry. Today was extreme winds. That would have just not been fun to go paddle around, especially without loaded down boats. I was not gonna go do that. And today's travel would all be straight into the wind and it would have been for hours. Went by this rocky drop-off here, and I've had luck for all sorts of fish near these sort of drop-offs before. So, as a last-ditch effort for Larry, I'm gonna just take a few casts and let my lure just sink off the drop-off. And then if I don't get any bites or anything, I'm gonna troll right back across the lake to camp, because the sun is setting very soon. The rain? It can be rain. Oh yeah, that's rain. Joyous day. Yes. Why wouldn't it rain? One last cast. For Larry. More cash just in case. Felt weird. It did not feel like snagging a rock or something. Oh, it's starting to rain. Ah, crap. Ah, jeez. Okay. It's starting to get dark and it's starting to rain. I need to get back to camp. Oh no. It's starting to actually rain. Oh no! No! Ugh. Oh jeez! Oh no! Oh crap! Ah jeez! Well, you know, sometimes you go fishing for Larry at the last light of the year and it starts to rain pretty good. Well, let's get home. Oh jeez. All this is Larry's vengeance. Larry, past Larrys are being like, hey, you know what? It's our turn to get you, you little turd. That's all this is. Nothing like paddling in the heavy rain in the dark, you know? I just hope a huge old gust of wind comes along, you know? Just, let's get some 40 mile an hour winds, why not? What the heck? Oh cool! There's the wind I was talking about. Great! Cool! Yeah! Swell!
coming down.
It's coming down. Oh my god.
Oh no.
No, 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 no. Don't do it, little guy. Don't do it.
Rooks.
Oh no. Monty saw him. Wow, he's brave. He's like dumb dogs. Oh, there he goes. Oh, oh, burgers.
Oh no. Watch out, Monty. Monty, Monty, that's gas. Don't breathe that in.
Okay, what we are having for the dinners today is funky spaghetti.
Are we sure this is 8 ounces? So if it's not, let's just try a little. Tastes good. Oh. Now we gotta be careful. If we had too much water, it could be a little soupy.
Okay, go ahead, yeah.
Just started to rain again. It's rained every day so far. Isn't that amazing? Right, Funk?
That's really great.
Is this your favorite?
I would like some thunderstorm. Maybe.
Yeah, I wish it would thunderstorm at night. This looks fairly hot. I feel like you're watching me.
I am.
Thanks, Aaron.
You're welcome.
Mmm. So good. See, the problem is that I want to eat it so fast.
The problem is you dig every bite from the very bottom of the bowl.
It's the sauciest there.
Eat some of the cooler stuff on top.
What?
You're gonna learn another lesson the hard way. Just like I did.
Fainting? Funk fainted once when she ate food that was too hot.
Burn.
We're on Owl Royal, and I brought a little wine along. And it was just after I did my wilderness first responder, and she took a bite of fish and just like, and then just fell face first onto the ground. And I had a little wine in me, so I was just like, oh, you just had a seizure.
No, I didn't have a seizure.
No, and then we realized she fainted.
It was hot food.
Face first onto the ground.
That's what happens, though. And then you swallow food too hot.
Yep, that's one of the side effects.
Your body's like, shut it down.
You just can't handle it.
Yes.
I'm over here and I can take it.
Your esophagus has probably just got severe burn damage.
Okay. We're going to finish eating up here. Get back in the tent. And pass out. I'm not sure if we're going to stay here tomorrow or not. But I think we might try fishing again. Funk really wants to get out for some morning fishing. So if we're staying here again, that'd make it even easier. We just got to hope for some no wins. So I'll check back in with you guys in a bit. It's night four. There's still wilderness out there. Couldn't catch a Larry's, but I ate all my spaghetti. Ruger's sleeping. Get up for fishing. Hopefully it's not windy. Okay, Rooks. Okay. Good night, everybody. Oh yeah, we just heard some wolves. And I couldn't record.
If I could close my mouth, if I could find a way, I'd probably have better breath going into another day. But it'll probably stay open. Look at those tiny chicklets. Yes, those are actually teeth. Look at me stick my finger there.
Good morning. Hi, Rugus.
Hi.
Hi, Montes.
Hi.
Oh, Funk's coming back. It's chilly outside.
It was raining. I'm pretty freezing again.
So we decided to sleep in. We're working on getting up. That's a Rugus tail. Oh, Rugus.
Oh, it's a chilly one this morning. The wind's changed directions. It's coming from this way now. You can see some snow in the air. It's definitely dropped a good 10 degrees since yesterday. So we're gonna have to change up the tarp again. And then we're probably gonna venture down that way and do some fishing. But yeah, definitely chilly. It hasn't dampened the boys' spirits. They have ripped off a fresh cedar tree branch. And they are now fighting to the death over it. Ooh, don't you let him get that, Monty. He thinks he's better than you. Oh.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. La da dee 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 da dee da. La da 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 da. La da dee.
Oh, it's chilly today. All right, we moved the tarp again. It is chilly out today. It is definitely colder than the rest of the week. We were supposed to get a temperature drop, and I think it's come a day early. We're doing the best we can with the tarp setups. Oh, Monty heard Ruger grab a stick. So I'm just filtering up some water, and then we're gonna cue off the coffee and breakfast sequence. And Ruger's gonna bring us a log. Come here, Rugs. Come here, Rugus. Come here. Come here. You have to come here closer. You're not here enough. Come here. Come on. Up. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. All right, lay down. Lay down on Dad's lap. There. Yeah. He's just like, I don't know about his dad. Oh. Yeah, yesterday we took, like I said, we did some extreme hammocking. And Funk laid down her sleeping bag and Ruger climbed up in between her legs and put his face up here, and then she covered them with their sleeping bag, and he just passed out for like an hour or two, just nestled into the sleeping bag on the hammock.
It's the best feeling in the world.
Yeah. Yeah, Monty does not prefer the hammock. When you get him up on the hammock, he's immediately just like tense and he will not be calm until you let him back on the ground. Otherwise, I would have done the same thing.
Yeah. Goofy.
Dang it. Ruger was chasing a partridge right into camp. There was a partridge like flying on our tarp. We're like, what is that? Ruger's chasing it. Ruger, that would have been a pretty tasty treat if you'd have got that one, pal.
Yeah, the boys just chased after some partridges. Some roofed grouse.
Here, no, Monty.
Oh. Funk brought out a Nalgene full of hot sauce for the rice and beans. The sun is gonna, but it'll warm us up.
Oh yeah. My little nose is so cold.
Does this stuff, do you even consider this stuff spicy?
No. I mean, it's a little kick to it.
Oh, it makes me sweat.
I mean, if you use a lot of it, I imagine it would be spicier. But then at that point, you're just eating it. You know? Just eating it to eat it.
Mm-hmm. Oh! Why did I swallow that? It was so hot. Well, we're just gonna eat up here. And then we're gonna decide what we're doing.
Hey, Funk, you warm under there?
I am warm under here. Caterpillar.
You're a little caterpillar?
Yeah.
It looks toasty.
Working together? Stick team? Monty's hot on his tail. Okay. And we are off. We are doing a little day adventure. The winds have died down. We got some cloudy blue skies, which means I need to put on the sunshades real quick. And I don't have my sunglasses with me. Where'd I put them last? Oh no. I was gathering firewood. Oh well. I have misplaced my sunglasses. I don't know where they are. So we're going without them. Which is a little unfortunate. It's fairly bright. It's gonna be especially bright if I'm facing the sun. But that's neither here nor there. The winds have died down. We can see that it's calm on the other shore, so we're gonna make our way to that side. And then we are going to do some fishing. Fishing? Oh yeah. You betcha.
Here.
Hey. You got a bite? Yeah? This is a perfect spot. Oh, that is a bite.
Okay. Almost right where I got a bite.
That's 100% a bite.
Right there at the end of that rock.
It doesn't feel big, whatever it is. I can't remember what it feels like to catch a fish. It's been so long.
Oh! Ruger, stay there! Oh, stay there, Rooks! Bobby Bass!
I caught a fish! I thought I had a snag. I would just cast it out and let it sit in the rocks and just kind of bounce off the bottom. Alright, sit down, Rooks. Alright. First fish of the trip. Thanks. It's not a monster, but it is a fish, and we are keeping it. Because we want fish dinner. We want a tasty little snack. We can't keep our Larrys anymore. We are day 5 into the trip, and this is the first fish that we've pulled out. So, yeah, may not be the biggest, but hey, we catch like 3 more like this, we're going to be eating good. All right, so I just cast it out and let it just sit on the bottom. Where have all the fishies gone? I want to catch one. Where have all the fishies gone? Long time ago. It's windy no matter where we go. We thought we were going completely out of the wind. It was calm for a second, and now it's just windy again. I'm just like blowing in circles. Rugs cannot help himself but look at this fish. He's just staring at it. Rugs.
Take a little break. Got some snow going on, or between snow and sleet. It's not rain, it's too frozen. It's definitely cold out. I think we're in the upper 30s today. It's a chilly one, especially with this wind. Mid to upper 30s. It's a chilly day. And the wind's definitely starting to pick up again, but we gotta go camp back behind this island, off in the distance back over there. We went over to there, paddled and fished all the way down here, following the whole shoreline to here. One fish so far, a couple bites. We're gonna hike up on this rock. We're gonna see if we can find a better view.
Monty. It's gorgeous.
Stay up here, Rube.
It's so warm up here. That's a beaut of a view.
That shore that we fish is all calm looking now.
Oh yeah. Completely glass over there now. Well, that was some gorgeous views. Gorgeous, just gorgeous. I was hoping to get a nice view like that. Very, very spectacular. Very, very good. So we got an island up here. We're gonna be working our way back to camp now. Funk's gonna fish the right side. I'm gonna fish the left side. The winds are not terrible. They're gusting and then they're stopping. So I got a little warm walking up there, hiking up that hilltop there. So shed a layer. But as far as the old Bobby Jr. goes, it's definitely, since the temperatures are in like the low 40s, and that's like the high, and with this wind, it's definitely like 40 or less. So we're gonna flay up that fish and keep it for tomorrow or the next day. If we don't catch more. If we catch at least three that size, we'll probably have them tonight. Otherwise, we're saving them for another day and we'll try fishing, because we had some bites on those lakes on the way here. We'll try those again. Funk, what's the international noise you make if you got a fish? What was that? How many did you catch?
All of them.
All of them? No wonder I didn't catch any. Just a stump. It's just a stump, Rooks. You don't like that stump? I don't think Rooks likes that stump.
Monty, how's it going down there? You nestled up? I think you two are on opposite ends of the spectrum there. You got the stick in your mouth and Monty's snuggled up in a sleeping bag. Yeah?
I'm
not cooked enough yet.
The doggy sweet potato primordial soup.
Fire. Punk's doing dishes. Rugs is chasing mice. Whoa. Well, it's hot. I'm gonna eat up here. Finish my food, we're gonna clean up camp, and then we are getting up pretty early and we are moving camps tomorrow.
What is it? You see something, Rubes?
Yeah, so I'm gonna finish up eating and then, yeah, we're getting back in the tent and getting ready for bed. You know, the same old drill. The same old drill, right, Monty? You cozy little critter?
Hey guys, Monty here. I can't keep my eyes open, I'm so tired. So, I'll catch you guys in the morning. Good night, everybody. Good morning. It's bright early. The sun just came up. So, okay, now get packed up. Make some coffee and breakfast oatmeal, whatever we make. So let's do it.
No, 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 no. No, no, no.
Oh, Monty won, Monty won. Monty got it, Monty got it. Ruger, you're gonna let him take it from you? Oh, come here. Come here, I've got more. Come here.
Yeah, it's pretty chilly. It's a lot chillier than it was inside the tent there. But yeah, we're gonna pack up and move. It's time to make some foods and poops. Make some foods and poops.
Okay, go ahead.
And fishing.
There, it'll stay a little bit dry
for the next people.
And we are off.
Four little portages for the day today. Unfortunately, they're all inclined. Three of them are really teeny. The first one is teeny as well, but it's pretty much climbing stairs the whole time. So, climbing stairs for an eighth mile. It's pretty steep, short and steep. So that is the first thing we've got to accomplish today. Ruger, can you accomplish sitting down?
Good boy. Yes, you did it. You did it.
Oh, it is a calm one today. We are hoping to catch some fish. The goal for today is a fish dinner. We got an earlier start than all the other days. A whopping hour and a half extra, which will all be dedicated to fishing. We're not going to fish this lake or the next lake. And then we're going to fish the next two lakes and the lake we're staying on tonight. The goal is for walleye and bass. Can't keep Larry's. So bass and walleye, I don't think we're going to catch many walleye. So pretty much we're going to be eating bass. Bobby bass. Oh, we've got a few snowflakes in the air. Think that means it's time to troll across this here lake. We haven't had one day without precipitation.
Take my paw, take my whole dog too, for I can't help Gopher Dog Park with you. Like a little dog sitting in the boat, he will surely float in the lake if he swims. Oh, Rugis Toos, Stinky Butt Badoos. Rugis Toos, Rugally Toos, Toos, Toos.
No.
You sound like gotta sound like you're concerned, like All right, it is time to catch a fish. All right, Rooks, leave it. Leave it, Rooks. Good boy. Nope, that was not quite leaving it. If there's water, there's fish. If there's fish, you'll catch them. Oh, that's better. Now I can see in the water a little better too. He's getting a little better about it. He's not like standing up for the lure. He just looks. Level 2 boat dog. I don't know. He could be more like level 3. I'd give him middle of the road because he's a pretty good dog.
Oh, I didn't set the hook.
Dang it. What the? Oh! No! It was a pike. Gah!
Oh, hey, it's that moose poop again.
Oh, I mean wolf poop.
Good job, Rugis.
This is the lake where I lost 2 pike on. The first 2 fish we had on. We need to catch something here. Because there's dead trees. And where there's dead trees, there's water. Where there's water, there's fish. Where there's fish, you'll catch them. You got a bite? Ooh. Sit down, Rugis. Just sit down for me. Oh my. You got fish? You need help? I'm coming. I just had a pike take. I'm coming. Ruger, sit down. Ruger, sit down. You're wibbling the boat. What is he wrapped around?
I can't see
either. Let me It's a dangerous game. Oh. You're wrapped around weeds is a problem. Try to reel down to it and kind of pull. Slowly pull. Keep going. Yep, you have to keep reel down more. He's stuck all in those thick millweeds. Tighten your drag a little bit. Keep doing it. Nice and slowly, just keep pulling it out. You have to rely on the strength of your line and just pull it out. Try getting a few pulls. Does it feel like it's gonna snap? Oh, is it coming? Let me see. There you go. Oh. It's a pike. Oh, there's Bug's pike. All right. Oh. Good job, you caught your fish. I had a pike snap my line. It's only like the sixth one this trip. We've got a bass. We've already decided what we'll do if we have to split the one bass. And that is we are gonna cut the pieces very small so you get more fried edges and you can make more tacos. Yeah, we're gonna make fish tacos. Yeah, it's gonna be delicious, but it would be nice to have a little bit more fish here. There we go. And it's a pike. Dang it. All right, Rugs, leave it. Sit. Rugs, sit. Okay. We've got a pike. We had a pretty Riley Rugs. Oh, Rugs. Oh, geez. There he goes. Dang it, and he got my worm, too. At least he didn't get... Let's see. No frays. We're good. Oh. What is happening? Oh, man. Peter Pike, hey? Leave it, Rugs. See, Rugs? Yeah. It's a fishy. All right, leave it, Rugs. There he goes. Back to the water from whence he came. Beautiful spot for some lunch. Good stuff. Funk's got the SS Wood Times all loaded up and ready to go.
Your half.
How about we just catch one more and then we don't have to worry about it?
Ooh! Oh! Stay there, Rooks. Stay.
Stay there, Rooks.
Yes! Bobby Bass! Another booby! Yeah! Booby, booby bass! Yes! Alright.
Feels good, man!
Alright. I'm not even gonna mess around. We're gonna get little booby on the stringer here. Okay, we've got some distance till camp. Funk's got the old rebel crayfish she's trolling. I'm gonna try, it's a mini version of the chartreuse slayer in black and white, which is a little more natural look. I haven't had a single bite on the chartreuse slayer this trip, and it's been cloudy the whole time. So now I'm gonna switch to natural colors and see if that does the trick. I don't even know why I bother. Anytime I have something other than the chartreuse slayer on, I'm like, well, I bet if I had the chartreuse slayer on, I would have caught a fish already. So it's better to just stick to one lure. That way, you don't have to wonder if the other lures work. If you only use one, then there's no worry. So as far as back to the levels of boat dog that Ruger and Monty are, we're gonna say that your level of boat dog is based on the amount of solid canoe adventures you've had. Now Ruger has been in the boat a bunch of times on overnighters and whatnot, but as far as being in the back with a food bag, portaging multiple times on lakes, I would say this is his third one. So that would make him a level 3 boat dog, and you've got to hit 10 to reach master level, to where that's probably going to be the way you are as a boat dog. Maybe more than that, but either way, Monty's, I don't even know how many he's been on, lots. Ruger, this is his third big adventure, being in the back. So all his adventures, he was a pup. This is his first one as a dog. Yeah, this is definitely the first one as a dog. He was a little pup. Yeah, we're talking about you, Rooks. You're a good boy back there in the boat, sitting down, laying down. Good boy, you stay there.
Hey, Monty. Hi.
Oh, bouncy bunny.
Come here. Come here, you bouncy bunny. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Alright, show the people your new trick. He's swimming. Oh, he's clapping his legs. Oh, he's swimming. He's clapping his legs. Cross. Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo. Good boy, Monty. That's a fancy trick. That's a fancy trick you got there.
So we've got ourselves a beautiful little campsite here. We're going to put the tent right here. Sitting over this beautiful view. No. So there's a reason, if you're wondering why I haven't done any sleeping pad battles with Monty this trip. Well, that's because Ruger's here. Now Ruger goes from 0 to 100 and he does not mess around. Monty's got a dopey little bite, but Ruger's already popped a pad this trip. That was with his foot. Imagine what he can do with his mouth. So I'm not messing around here. I'm not trying to pop two pads this trip.
Ooh.
No.
Hey. Okay. I surrender. Okay, so we've got our fish filleted up. We're gonna try something a little different for the tuna tacos. So we've got the boys, fish tacos. We've got them sliced really thin so we can put more batter and get them like crispy little fingerlins. So what I need you to do, Funk, is to put a little batter in there. Go right next to that Steve.
Ew, get that out of here.
Get out of here, Steve. Get. Yeah, Steve, no, you get out of here. Okay, we've got a few things to prepare for our fish tacos, and the first being cabbage. We're gonna make a cabbage slaw, so I'm gonna do my best to slice very thin on the cabbage. You want me to touch it with my fishy hands?
Yes, please do.
So, then next we've got to slice up some lemons. Well, I should roll these a little bit. Help get them juices flowing. Yeah. Lemon juice in here. I'm gonna add in a little sprinkle of Montreal. Ooh, and then should we add a little touch of vegetable oil? Huh? A little splash. There we go. Now we're just gonna mix this up, and that will be some delicious cabbage slaw. Lemony Montreal-y cabbage slaw for the tacos. Oh yeah. Alright, I don't know if he's made it this whole week. Let's find out. I brought out some aguacate. Ooh.
What?
Yeah, there we go. We're having avocado. Oh, I made it.
Perfect avocado. Other than that, I don't like eating that.
All right, and then of course we've got the boys' sweet potato. We've got to save half a sweet potato for tomorrow. So I'm just gonna dice up their sweet potato quick. And then, yeah, it's time to get the oil heating up and get to cooking. Here's the pot for the oil. Funk's gonna have water for our potatoes eventually. She's having technical difficulties. Some oil.
You know, someone asked how to get your dog to sleep in a sleeping bag. Well, Rubes wasn't really a dog that slept in a sleeping bag till this trip. He hasn't really got a chance, but all you gotta do is have it cold enough and have it be available, and they'll seek it out. Rugs, it wasn't folded over, but he crawled. We placed this on the ground, and he just crawled over to it, nestled into it, and then we just folded it over to him, and look at him, he's just passed out, just loving it. That's a good boy, Rugs. Yes, that's a good boy.
A gentleman and a scholar at this.
Ooh, your fish is almost ready. Ooh, they're crispy little nuggets. I think there's gonna be a lot there. Okay, Monty's mangled mush. Looking extra mangly and mushy. So I'm gonna get them all as best I can on the... Oh, it's a hot fire. Well, this is dangerous. We've got to slice up some extra sharp cheddar. Ooh. Try to slice a little thinner. Okay. And you put the slaw on top?
I want cheese, hot fish, slaw, hot sauce.
Okay. I'm gonna try the same thing, okay. Okay, now I just need my hot fish, and we will prepare the rest of the taco. Oh wait, no.
I've got aguacate.
I need to place my crispy hot pieces of fish on my tacos. Oh, man. Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. This is going to be so good. Right on top. Oh my gosh, it is going to just be so delightful eating this. Oh, that's like the perfect amount. Oh my gosh. Ooh, there's a little extra juice I got in there. That's okay. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Squiggles. Let's eat. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, go ahead. Oh yeah.
I have a few bites of these.
There are no words for how delicious this is right now. So, I'm gonna stop that camera, continue to make a mess with my hands. Ruger, get back. Hey, get back. Yeah. We've got a whole bunch of crap to clean up. Big ol' mess. This is so delicious. So yeah, I'm shutting off that camera. We're gonna eat the rest of this in peace. Clean up all our mess, and then we'll check back in with you. In the tent here, got the little Rugus next to me. Rugus was not trained in the art of the sleeping bag before this, and we weren't sure if he ever was going to be a sleeping bag dog, but you just bring them out in the colder temps, and when they're running around, you just nestle them up, and hopefully, like Ruger here, they just realize that that's warmth and they start seeking it out. And Ruger is completely sealed up in a sleeping bag. He's not zipped up, but he's completely nuzzled in, and he's loving it. He is just loving it. So Ruger is now a sleeping bag dog. Good old Monty over here. Always a fan of the sleeping bag. Never afraid. But now we got another one. So anyways, we're going to pass out. So I'll catch you guys in the morning. Good morning, Monty. Oh, little dentist Rooks.
Oh, good morning. Well, I slept pretty good. What about you, Funk? Yeah, what about you, Rooks? Lay down, Rooks. Lay down. Don't lick my face. Don't lick. Oh, so today is the final full day of the Fall Boundary Watchers week-long trip. Oh, So we've got 4 portages for the day. Bit more paddling than yesterday. Might wet my lines a few times throughout the day. But it's a little brisk morning. I'm sure it'll be a little colder once we get out of the tent. But yeah. We're about to get up, make some coffee, make some oatmeal or rice and beans, and make a poop, and then get moving. So let's do it.
Well, hi. Good morning. Okay. Shh. No.
It's a beautiful morning out there.
Wouldn't you say it's not as cold as yesterday, Funk?
No, it's not as cold as yesterday.
No. Well, it's time to cue coffee and oatmeal sequence.
Window. Please tell me that doggy's for sale.
No. What?
It's the wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
It's still there. Ooh, it's hot. Well, if this just isn't the best place to eat breakfast, overlooking a fall wilderness. So, we're pretty much, what, 90% packed up?
I'm like 97.
97? Oh, I got some catching up to do. So, I'm just going to finish up my breakfast here, clean up, and we're going to get on that water to paddling, portaging, and what else, Funk?
he's being.
That.
Come on. Hey, you just jumped right, you just went for it, Rooks. There was no hesitation whatsoever.
And we are off.
I'd say a few leaves have fallen. Yeah, those 2 days of wind. Definitely some leaves have fallen. But today's a little bit warmer than it was yesterday. It's still got a nip to the air. It's nice and brisk, but it's definitely not as cold as yesterday. And as far as a reference of temperatures, I just want to touch base on that for a quick second. So you'll note that sometimes I'll be out when there's snow on the ground and it's like 50 degrees and I'm in a t-shirt, sunglasses, and I'm saying it's hot. Well, temperatures are relative. I brought this up before, but right now we are going from summer into winter. So my body is used to the, you know, 70s and 80s, and it's been a really warm summer, so I'm all used to that. And then you stick me in some 40s and 50s, it's gonna seem cold. Now, you stick me in a winter camping season all winter and I'm sitting there going in teens and stuff, just waking up, you know, you get used to that. And then going into 50s and 40s again is really warm. So it's all relative. Just like if you're down in lower, you know, you're down in like on the Pacific Ocean or like Florida or Texas or something like that, and it's really hot all the time, you know, 40s and 50s is gonna seem really cold. You're up on the shoreline of the Antarctic Ocean, you know, 40s and 50s is gonna seem pretty dang warm. So it's all relative. And this actually, this trip is, you know, it's been quite chilly being in the 40s and windy. That's gonna get me prepared pretty well for winter camping. That helps a lot. Because if I were to go straight from like summer camping straight into just snow on the ground, it'd be a little chilly that first winter camp. The first one's always the coldest. But this is a nice little buffer between winter, because, you know, with trips like these, especially because it's been in the 30s every night, I think it might have dipped to the 20s, not last night, the night before, but it got pretty cold. But you never really get a chance to get just like completely warmed up. Like, you don't get hot ever on a trip like this. I mean, we were getting pretty warm on some of the portages and you're roasting by the fire, but it's just for a little bit. For the most part, you know, you're chilly the whole time. And that definitely gets you used to the cold temperatures quick.
That's all I have to say about that.
Monty, I see your little face. I see your face sticking up out of that canoe.
Monty.
Yeah, the leaves are definitely a little darker.
It's just less yellow.
Yep.
More
yep.
Trees.
Definitely.
Especially here,
yep.
Aaron, what did you do? What have you done? Because you didn't put it on shore enough. You better hope my stick's deep enough. I could paddle with this anyways. It's going so fast. Okay. Now what do I do? How's my hat hair? Hey. I found this boat in the lake. You want it? So, next time we leave our boats, what are we gonna do? Pull it up a little further. We've got three lakes left in the trip. There's not enough time to not troll. Haven't caught a Walter or a Larry. I think this may be the first trip ever that I've not caught a Larry the Lake Trout when I've gone to lakes where I've been targeting them. Try to think. Oh man. That would be no good. Well, I'm just gonna keep trolling. Like I said, you hear that, Mother Nature? I've never done a trip and not caught a lake trout. Okay, you hear that? You better hear it good. We've got a nice drop off here. We're going to take a few casts. There's a fish. Oh, it's a nice old Larry. Oh, it's a big old Larry. All right, I could totally net this guy right now, but I'm not gonna. Oh, Rupert, leave it. Oh, I let him go.
Doesn't count.
It counts. It counts enough for me. I didn't want to net him. Dang it. It almost doesn't count. I was just dealing with my rat's nest and I was pulling it up and I got one on. Is it another Laker? Oh yeah. It looks like the same one. All right, leave it, Rugs. Leave it, Rugs. Thank you, Mother Nature, for allowing us to catch a lake trout. It's okay, Rooks. It's okay. Oh, he's barely. You gotta wet your hands before you touch these trout. Look at the beautiful colors on that guy. All right, let's let him go. Just perfect timing, Larry. Just perfect. Right when we can't keep him anymore, the Larrys show up. It's like he knew.
What you got there, Funky?
Got me a Larry.
Got you a Larry? Is that what it is? The Larrys are just a few days too late. Dang it. Oh man, I wish we would have fished here. It looked like a nice drop off just for fish in general. I just wish we would have fished here on our first time through. I was thinking to, but yeah,
It's okay. But anyways, hey, we didn't get skunked on the Larrys. That makes me happy. Caught a couple Larrys there.
Yeah, that makes me happy.
I was just saying, if I get skunked on Larrys. These are really pretty Larrys. Like, they had really colorful fins, almost look like brook trout. Maybe they're a crossbreed of some kind, but yeah, definitely had like the red orange fins.
Funk, do you hear that?
It's wilderness.
Blue squies.
Blue squies. They do exist.
I know I've mentioned it multiple times, but Rugus, this is his third major canoe trip. It's the third time he's been in the back of the boat for a multi-night canoe adventure with portaging. So he is doing amazing for only his third time. I mean, he's been in the boat plenty, canoeing around, and he's usually way more frantic for lures and stuff, but he's been really good this trip. There's a good boy. And he's already sitting down again. That's a good boy, Rugus. It is just a beautiful day. There's a little bait fish or something.
I might have to wet a line.
Since I've got such a good track record with skipping teeny tiny little 30 rod portages, I might try to skip one right now. It's the final portage of the trip, and I'm feeling a little lazy. Perhaps I just want to paddle down this one, down this little river, and not get out of my boat. Let's see how it works out. Oh, I was just singing a song and reading my map, paddling in the middle of the lake, and I just rammed into these rocks. Oh, sorry, Rugs. I'm sorry. That'll happen, you know. Dad's a ding-dong sometimes. He's not paying attention. Take that 30 rod portage. Was gonna have to do the last portage of the season, but we skipped it. No hiccups so far. Look at that beautiful big lake, and there's just no waves, no wind. It's the perfect day to paddle across this here lake, you know?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah, you betcha.
If you look right here, this island and this island are burned, but this one right in the middle is unburned. The fire jumps across the water by embers being carried, so that one's untouched right in the middle. But these two on the side got leveled by the flame. It's kind of crazy. Okay, so originally we were gonna do our seven nights, and then I had a little surprise in mind for Funk, but she didn't have the extra day off to do that little surprise. So she's just gonna have to go home and go to work the next day after tonight. So what I guess I'm saying is, if Funk is okay with it, we're gonna head out of here a day early and we're gonna get a hotel, because that was my surprise. Unless she doesn't want to. You want to do it? Yeah. You sure?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because we are making great time. And we are just cruising across this big old lake. Like, you can see, it's a huge lake. And it's just like no waves, no wind. We are making great time. We had a blast on this trip. So, yeah, I wanted to, you know, have some fun, get a hotel with the dogs. But we don't have enough nights, and since we're so close to the car anyways, we're just gonna scoot on out and go get a hotel, get cleaned off, and get some good grub. You know, we've got another 45 minutes of paddling, I'd say. Maybe a little bit more, but yeah. Well, we had an awesome trip. Beautiful fall colors. The colors have definitely changed since we've been here. They were a lot lighter yellow, I would say. I wouldn't say crazy amounts. Maybe it's just my brain telling me that, but only the footage will tell. But I think there's definitely a lot darker yellows and a lot less leaves from what I remember seeing on the way in just six nights. We caught some fish. I don't want to say we caught a ton of fish, because we caught some fish. We caught enough for a meal. We got our Larry. I would have been so upset if we didn't catch a Larry. No moose. Had a little partridge in camp and some loons and beavers. But no moose. I've been missing out on moose. It's been a whole season mooseless. Yeah, I haven't. 2020, no moose. Dang. Ruger is laying down. Look at this dog back here. I mean, this is now a boat dog. Right, Rugs? It's a boat dog. Look at him. We've got, like I said, about 40 minutes left of paddling. If that, we are just making so much time. It might even be more like 20, 30 minutes at the rate we're going. But, yeah, ate some delicious food. Beautiful temperatures, my favorite time of year. And part of me is like, I want to stay out another night, but the other part of me is like, it would be a blast to hang out with the dogs in a hotel. And that was kind of the plan from the get-go, secretly in my head. So, I think that's going to wrap this one up, guys. So as always, if you like the video, hit the like button. If you want to see more stuff like this, hit that subscribe button, and I will catch you guys at the next video. Be free. That's a wrap.